Scientists only believe what they prove and see. How about you? They also have to see us to believe principle? This might be one of the reasons why some people were shown heavenly visions, because God wants to prove that heaven is real, that there is blessed assurance for all our hardships, faithfulness, and perseverance in running the race, that our objectives here on earth is not only earthbound. I used to have scientific mind. I didn't believe anything based on a story like a mouthpiece without evidence unless I prove or see it myself. In this video, I'm going to share some of my heavenly experiences. Truth is, I was made aware and corrected. The first one is about walking along the crystal clear water. My paternal grandfather died years ago. I love him so much. Then I got this dream that left me wonder when my grandfather brought me to a seemingly paradise where water and natural resources abound. He held my right hand so tight and we walked along a narrow river that seemed endless and boundless. At first, I was afraid to walk along the river, fearing I might fall in it and get drowned. But my grandfather never left me. He held my hand so tight without saying a word. The water is so clean, clear, and full of life. It overflows, but our feet never get soaked. Our walk seemed never ending. We followed the flow of the river and then went back our way again. It's as if the course of that adventure is merely walking and enjoying each other's company. We never had a chance to talk. He simply smiled at me. He looked so happy and contented, and his face got a little younger than his current age as I remembered years ago when he was still alive. After that dream, I felt so refreshed and hopeful. That wonderful heavenly experience was with my grandfather. How much more if it's God who is with me at that time? Anyway, there is really a river in heaven which cleanses all our impurities, sadness, and bad memories. The second one is about the big black book. After I graduated college, I dreamed about myself in heaven. How I get there is a long story to tell. Well, allow me to focus only on what I experienced there. I was inside a big, wide, endless room since I cannot see any wall. My eyes can't find a ceiling, though I know there is, and I am inside a room all in white. The floor is so shiny, made of marble, and is also very white. I am wearing all white too. Next thing, I sat on the floor, and a black book appeared on my hands. I'm not sure how big it was, but I know it was handy and that I can able to grasp it by one hand. Then some unseen force opened it, and right before my eyes, I could see my name written in it. Some letters and words were fading away and unreadable. Other words appeared which read as, "Keeper of the Apostle." The words were addressed to me as I was puzzled then. I didn't know what those words mean. Of course, I literally understood, but it's hard to decide what to do with it. I know there was someone along with me, a man with long white beard wearing all white. Strangely though, he didn't utter even a single word to let me know what was happening. Then another name appeared from the book. I knew whose name it was. Along with it were some adjectives describing the person and giving me a warning not to trust and hence stay away from that person. I felt sad about it because that person was my coworker. He was so nice and friendly to me. Later, I realized that my dream about him was a warning. I don't have to mention what it was, but I really thank God for saving and protecting me from danger. Through Jesus loves me. He never wants me to be harmed. However, what greatly disturbed me were the words "keeper of the apostle." It seemed a task to be accomplished. The reason that heavenly person accompanying me told me to get back to earth, saying, "You still have some things to do. You have to go back." That dream I had years ago about the book being shown to me was something to do with my life. From March to July 2013, I left my full-time job due to my desire to focus on studying God's word. I did not regret. In fact, God blessed me more than I expected during those 4 months I studied His word. In my part-time job, He gave me so much joy, humility, and contentment. I did not lack finances. My Father in heaven is so true to His promises in Matthew 6:33. I know that during those 4 months, God was testing my patience and humility. He gradually had taken away my earthly desires and replaced it on its own godly desire, taught me to be totally dependent on Him. And when He found I am worthy of the task, He released me. I resumed my full-time job. On July 15th, I completed the whole New Testament of the Bible at 2 a.m. It was an accomplishment. Then after that, I received an email from my current employer asking me if I'm ready to work again. My friends, housemates, and part-time colleagues told me I'm so lucky to have as much of the leave absence as I wanted to, because other companies don't usually allow such. I don't call it luck, it is God's favor. The third one is about rapture and tribulation. Since childhood until now, I have had experiences seeing rapture in my dream with different settings, time, and situation. For instance, we were in this particular bus. My mom and my sister were in different bus too. Buses on the roads were in a hurry just to reach the finish line before the specific set of time. There is a deadline. Then I heard a loud bell, like a siren in somewhere. Finally, I could see the clock, the short hand pointing at 11, and the long hand is running at 5 minutes before 12 midnight. We were so thrilled by the deadline. We want to make it on time. Yet, I woke up and didn't know if we made it. There were more similar dreams about rapture after that, such as bombs and rockets falling from heaven and people are escaping and we need to enter a particular building like airport or school with a particular mark in our hand. Without the mark, we cannot get in or out. Yet, while chaos had been taking place outside, there was this gigantic net that traps the missiles and protected us, so we can run freely away in the field. I believe that was the hand of God. So, no matter what happens in the world, God would protect us. The fourth one is about Jesus Christ in the white stairway. In my dream, I saw Jesus wearing white long robe floating above the white stairway. All around Him were so bright, though as I could remember, the sun was not shining at that moment and the sky was covered with clouds. Each staircase was spectacularly white. It's so shiny and bright. I've never seen such kind here on earth, so I couldn't say exactly what's it made of. It's material kind of made of fluorescent lamp, but much thicker, harder, and stronger. The steps have long gaps. I wonder how a mortal man could step up on it when each gap doubled the length of our legs. I don't even know how to split, because I assume this is the last option from a humanly perspective. Below the stairway, I could see many people wanting to climb on it to heaven. Then there's a commotion. People were battling and fighting each other just to climb the stairs. I could see their selfish intentions practicing crab mentality. Finally, I saw me pushing myself up. I really tried hard to stretch my legs to climb each step on top. Before I knew whether I successfully propelled myself, someone's hand gripped around my legs, which woke me up. On bed, I cried because I wasn't able to finish the course of my dream. I was really eager to climb each step of the stairways to be saved. I know that the scripture is right. It is really so hard to enter into heaven. The road is narrow and not straight. Read Matthew chapter 7, verse 13 to 14. It says, "Go in through the narrow gate, because the gate of hell is wide and the road that leads to it are easy. And there are many who travel it. But the gate to life is narrow, and the way that leads to it is hard, and there are few people who find it." The fifth one is about places of heaven. On November 20, 2019, I got a taste of heaven in my dream again. But the thing that left me in awe was the message by the heavenly being. I'm not so sure whether that heavenly being is an angel or a saint, but surely it's a male. He said, while leading us into different places of heaven, "The reason why visitors here don't enjoy much, neither get access to every places here in heaven, is because they are always in a hurry." The Holy Spirit of God instantly translated what he said for me. That simply means, people on earth don't crave themselves with the things of heaven because they don't have any idea what's in heaven. They no longer focus on things which are holy, pure, and godly, neither seeking the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God, because people on earth have enough of the pleasure of the world. The modern society bombarded people with too much entertainment that we can't have time for God. If I have to share the whole dream, this could be too long, like how I could describe heaven, the first heaven, second, third, fourth, and so on. With the absence of time and space was so colorful, lively, and serene. The colors of the flowers, plants, and landscapes was so clear or well saturated. Finally, from heaven, I was transported back to earth, wherein I landed on the ground full of dirts and grasses with a woman seducing me to buy dirt. The people around me seemed captivated of her enticing words, although what she's selling were all not good for the health and rubbish. In fact, literally she's also selling pig's dung. Then I was carried in an open field with people so busy running, seemed like there's a coming calamity, war, or something. Friends, regardless of whether we experience heavenly visions or not, what's important is our knowledge that there is really heaven, that God is watching our whereabouts. He is sitting in His throne in heaven, yet His eyes are also upon us. He is everywhere because He is omnipresent God. Don't ever think that God has not seen you. Let us pray. Dear God, truly you are a living God, and your Spirit is speaking to us in many different ways. Forgive us for our shortcomings and iniquities, and help us to be more vigilant for the upcoming events that only by your grace we could survive. Help us to be prepared for your second coming that will focus on you as a perfecter of our faith with you. Lord, help us to have a teachable heart to humble ourselves every time you correct us. Teach us to love others, especially those who hurt us, and we may forgive them as you forgive us. In Jesus' name, amen.